Professor Nimisha Goswami, you are welcome in online series of machine design. So in machine design, in particularly internal combustion engine, in today's session or in today's lecture we learn valve gear mechanism, how it is work, what are the basic parts of valve gear mechanism, and what is the material used for the valve gear mechanism, and what which type of valve is generally used in IC engine. Okay, so we know valves are generally used for the inlet and exhaust port. Okay, when we have to give the fuel inside of the engine and we have to exhaust the remaining gases, useful gases, we have used the energy from the useful gases which is generated inside of your internal combustion engine, and remaining wastage parts of the gases we will discharge to the surrounding. Okay, so by using these all valve gear mechanism, we can do all these basic requirements. Okay, so valve gear mechanism, or it is used in IC engine, which is consist of those parts which are actuated by inlet and exhaust valve at the required time. Okay, so here time fundamental is very important. You can see here, okay, time with respect to time. Okay, when we have to give the inlet of the fuel, and we have to, when we have to discharge the remaining gases, so these are totally, or these valves are work with respect to time or with our required time. Okay, so and with respect to what is the position of this position of your piston and crankshaft. So time and position of crankshaft, position of piston is very important, right? Next, so here in next diagram you can see here valve gear mechanism for vertical engines and for your horizontal engines. So this is your diagram. You can see here two separate diagrams are used for your vertical engine and for your horizontal engine. Okay, so what is the basic fundamental of this diagram? Okay, so you can see here we use the can and follower fundamental. Means can, what is the can and follower mechanism we have already seen in theory of machine. Okay, so can and follower means when motion of the can is transferred to your follower and that transferred to your push rod. So first of all, you can see in this diagram this this valve gear mechanism is consist of can follower mechanism, which is an push rod. So these are the basic parts, right? A tappet, screw, rocker arm, and finally spring and ball. Okay, so this is your basic, these are your basic parts of your valve gear mechanism. So when can is rotated by using the, or it is mounted on camshaft, right? Can is mounted on camshaft. So when camshaft will be moved, so can is also moved, and that will transfer your motion to the follower, and that motion of the follower will be transferred to your push rod. And by transferring from push rod to your tappet screw, and it transfer to your rocker arm. So what will rocker arm will do? It will transfer these force here. It will provide the compression, right? So what will happen to the spring? It will compressed, right? And valve will open. Similarly, when this can will be go in this direction, downward direction, so that spring will be, what will happen? It will be go onward. Okay, or in upward direction. So in that case, valve will be closed. So this is the basic fundamental of valve gear mechanism. Similarly happen with your horizontal engines, right? So next is your, you can see here I have put a one example of here can and follower mechanism. How can is rotating? So how follower is following the motion of your can? So you can see here clearly and better understand by using this animation. Next is your, the, so how fuel is admitted? Okay, so the fuel is admitted to the engine by the inlet valve, and burnt gases will be escaped through the exhaust valve. So this is the basic fundamental we all know, right? Next is your poppet valve. Okay, so what is poppet valve? Why I have put this basic fundamentals of your puppet board, because we have to design the puppet, or you can say that mushroom ball. So you can see in this diagram, this is basic function of your puppet ball, or you can say that mushroom ball. So there are basically in internal combustion engines, so there are basically three types of balls are used. First is your puppet or mushroom ball, second is sleeve ball, and third one is your rotary ball. But generally we prefer the puppet or mushroom ball for the basic or practical applications. So we have to design the puppet or mushroom ball. Clear? So puppet and mushroom ball look like this. So you can see here, it is look like this. It is consist of your head. You can see here head. Okay. So it is consist of your head, face, seat and stand, and spring retainer. Okay. So these are the basic parts of your puppet or mushroom ball. Okay. And we have to design each and every part of your ball. Means we have to find out the DS, diameter of your seat, right? Then we have to find out the diameter of your head, and we have to design the face. Okay. So we will find, we will design the mushroom ball in next lecture. Okay. So here we will complete the basic fundamentals of ball. So you can see here, here margin is given between your head and face. Okay. Here head is this portion, here face. So here margin is given. So margin is given to operate the ball properly without any problem. Okay. So the stand is also available at, face is available at 45 degree. Okay, so it's vary from the 30 to 45 degree. So these are the standard data. Okay. Next is your, the head and face of the ball is separated by a small margin. I have already explained in your diagram. Okay. Head and face is separated by a small margin to avoid the sharp edges. Okay, so this is the basic fundamental, sharp edge of the ball, and it is also used to provide the provision of regrinding of the face. By operating, continuously operating the ball in your IC engine, there may be regrinding may be required of the face. Okay, so that's why we provide the margin. Okay, and face angle I have already explained, it varies from 30 to 45 degree. Okay, and lower portion we have seen in this diagram. Here you can see here that lower portion and this portion is known as your stand. Okay. So the lower part of the stand is provided with a groove in which spring retainer is there. Okay. Installed. Okay. So spring retainer lock is installed. We have seen it like that. So what is the material or ball should use? Okay. We know in internal combustion engine, there is very high temperature and pressure may be produced. Okay. So to withstand that high temperature and pressure, material and what is the range of that temperature? So it varies from the 1930 degrees centigrade to 2200 degrees centigrade. Okay. During the power stroke. So in power stroke, temperature is very, very high. Okay. So it is required, it is compulsory that material of the ball should withstand that type of the temperature. If material will be fail out, means your overall design of internal combustion engine will be failed, right? So material of the valve is very important, so that can withstand that much of high temperature. So material of valve should have the good heat conduction. Why heat conduction? So it transfer the heat continuously. Okay, and it should be heat resistant. It not fail by using that much of temperature. If maximum temperature will be reached, so material should withstand that much of your temperature. And next is corrosion resistance. So it should avoid the corrosion material of the wall, and it should have the wear resistance also, and shock resistance, because there is a reversible, or your camshaft is rotating continuously. Okay, so there may be fatigue, may be possible. So wall should have the capacity to resist that shock resistance. Okay, so by using that all properties, it may be noted that temperature of the inlet valve is less as compared to exhaust valve, right? So by using this fundamental, we will design the valve, or we use a different materials for the valve. So generally, inlet valve is generally made of your nickel and chromium alloy. Okay, you can see here, it is generally made of nickel or chromium alloy steel, and exhaust valve is subjected to very, very high temperature. Okay, so it is made of your silk chrome steel. So it is a silicon chromium steel alloy. Okay, silicon means silicon chromium and steel alloy. So exhaust valve are made of this. Okay, so it is a I have already explained, it is a basic alloy of silicon and chromium and steel. Okay, so thank you, keep watching.